My name is Roy Dar. I'm a postdoctoral fellow here at the Gladstone Institutes. Our lab works on HIV latency, because HIV, currently there are a lot of drugs that can keep it suppressed, but that suppression, you can't keep it suppressed forever. Eventually, if you take the drugs away, then the virus comes back. So that's what a large community is working on, is how do you fully eradicate or fully eliminate HIV? On a given day in our lab, really it's very diverse ops. So there's a lot of stuff going on in the background. At the same time, you have your lab group and different meetings and activities with them and people that you have to interact with. You have your own projects. You have either fellowships or papers of your own that you have to write, grant proposals that you have to write. So there's a lot of different tasks that are either that span from individual work to group work to just being part of a community. And you have to find a way to balance all those different tasks and be involved in all of them because you can benefit from them. It's hard to define what the work hours are, because if you're at home in the evenings and you're enjoying solving this problem, you know, you're working on some solution or working on some data set, then I don't know. It's, you could call it work, but I call it science. And I don't know if science is a job. So what you're looking at here is an automated fluorescence microscope. And what it enables us to do is to image cells over long periods of time. Let's say 24 hours or 48 hours, you have to make sure that this really sensitive equipment doesn't move at all. It doesn't shake, because otherwise it'll go out of focus. So this is called an air table. It's usually used whenever you have sensitive optic equipment on it. And you can see that when I push it down, it pops back up. It's gonna be able to buffer between your experiment and the sample and the vibrations that are coming up from the ground that we usually typically don't even care about or feel. We don't want to have light contamination to a long two-day experiment, for example. So what we have here is a curtain that we use to block all the lighting and keep the microscope in a dark environment. So what we do is we turn off the light and then we just disappear into the darkness. So I actually didn't apply myself academically until well after high school. I guess in high school I was more interested in extracurricular activities and sports, and I wasn't the AP or the 4.0 student. So I grew up in the Bay Area. I went to high school in Los Altos, so South Bay. Then I moved to Israel, and I lived in Israel for 7 years, and I did my undergraduate at the Hebrew University in Jerusalem. So if I go back to my path, where I started in physics or math, not to put down those fields at all, they're very important, but I felt a huge difference when I was working on problems that can actually relate to the world around me, to people around me. And I think that's a big benefit. But I think biomedical research is one of those that you can do science, you can do engineering, you can do research, you can make a good living, and at the same time know that the product of your sweat and your work is going towards a really good cause. But science is great. You're missing out if you're if you're gonna choose something else. So.